always knew he was colourful.
He's too tall, too big.
With that hair and the way he walked.
He was very funny.
Marco is a great man, you know, like everybody see on television. He's really genuine, he's really easy, he's like a nice boy, you know.
Most of the riders, we were a little bit, worried always when he was around, because we knew he will attack, and we always wanted to protect our position.
He was a really big rival from when we start to race in a pocket bike, from when I had 8 years old. So, I mean, many years I make my career with him. When he decides to overtake you, he, in any case, overtake you. This is a problem, because if I brake late and he can't stop, boom, we can make a crash.
He was, had a lot of good years ahead of him. I don't think everybody saw that. He had a lot of talent, overzealous at sometimes, but it just showed his character. And one that's going to be missed.
We battled a lot of in 250 overall, fighting for the world championship. And yeah, sometimes he was a little bit out of the limit on the track.
Mostly of the times he ride with the heart than with the head, you know. And for this reason, have sometimes some problem with the other riders, especially because you never want fight with Simoncelli, because he's always very difficult, and he was very big.
To be honest, I feel sorry to what happened to him, because maybe if we could speak more close as a person and not as a riders, mediatic riders, maybe we can manage more the situation and take some more conclusions. Marco was really hard to beat on the body to body, you know. For me, I think a real man.
I was in Italy, and I don't know so much about Italy, and I don't speak Italian, so he looked after me and he was very kind. He wasn't a really big friend to me, so I didn't expect this sensation, and it was really hard. I went to the family Tuesday, I went to the house, his house. I never thought to be in the house of Marco. To give the support, I don't know how much support I can give to his family, but that family is really strong, so.
I think I'm quite privileged to have been on the podium with him both times this year, and he will be missed a lot throughout this paddock.
The most important is to never forget him, and I think, especially for me, he can remain in my heart always.
It's hard to arrive in Valencia without him.
Some wonderful tributes there from the men who knew him best as a rider and as a rival. I'm joined now by a man who knew him very well as a person, Kevin Schwantz, of course, the 1993 world champion, MotoGP legend. Kev, what are your memories of this fantastic young man?
Well, I mean, everything he did as fast and as hard as he could do it, whether it was riding motocross with him or racing go-karts with him or, driving around his BMW. It was living life, you know, to the very top, as having as much fun as he possibly could. And that was the same way he raced. He raced every lap like it was the last one. And just nothing but great memories.
You had the great honor this morning of taking his bike out on a parade lap, joined by the rest of the MotoGP riders and many from the Moto2 and 125s as well. What was that like?
You know, it was a fitting tribute. It was neat to see the all the excitement from the fans as we went around the track, and it was really neat to hear all the other motorcycles behind us too making the noise, which you know, was what Simoncelli liked. He liked to make noise, and I think it was a fitting tribute.
He was a hero to a lot of, especially the young guys out there on the grid with you.
Absolutely, and you know, one of the real characters of this sport, one of the guys who I think had an absolute brilliant future, and you know, it's a shame, but I think everybody has fond memories of him.
Well, absolutely, Kevin. We couldn't have thought of a better person to be out there on his bike. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Okay, well, following that lap, there was exactly what Marco's father had requested from the MotoGP paddock, a noisy tribute to his son. Just have a listen to this. Yeah, truly a fitting way to remember a man, guys, who thrived on creating a spectacle.
Yeah, it was never dull, was it? There was always plenty of colour and movement with him. But the reason he was so attractive was he was cool. He was a real dude in the paddock. Didn't care.
And you can tell from those tributes, he might have ruffled a few feathers, but there's an awful lot of respect for him out there, not just as a rider, as a person as well.
Yeah, some wonderful tributes for him throughout the paddock this weekend, Charlie.
Yeah, let's not forget what a controversial character he was. People like Danny Pedrosa and Lorenzo wanted him banned a few months ago, so it is nice that they remember his clever bits.
Of course, we'll never forget Marco, but we remember him everywhere we look this weekend. Steve, it's been an emotional weekend.
Yeah, it's been a terrible few weeks, hasn't it, with Dan Weldon as well. We lost him, but with Marco, it just was like we've lost a member of the family, and it has been very fitting what's gone on here this weekend. The fireworks were very spectacular, the whole thing about it, and you feel very sorry for his family and friends. But we will move on.
Yeah, Loris Capirossi there running the number 58 actually this weekend for his final ever Grand Prix appearance. The poster that you saw all the riders signing there was actually for us, and we're going to auction that for Children in Need, so keep a look out for details for that a little bit nearer to the time. And of course